Pocoyo and the League of Extraordinary Super Friends. Ah, outer space, a place full of mystery. What is that? It looks like a meteorite. Wow, awesome. It seems like we have a visitor. It's an angry alien. And you come in peace, don't you? Oh, no! Fred Fury is right. We need help. Oh my, look at all those suits. Wow, Super Pato Magneto. Oh, you don't like it? Super Green Pato. Okay, you don't like this one either. Super Vintage Pato. Nope, you definitely don't love it. Wonder Pato. No. Super Professor Pato. Okay, that's a no-go. Oh, Super Shadow Pato. Wow, Pato, this one looks great on you. That's just brilliant. Super Shadow Pato. And here they come. Super Elly and Super Doll. What is that tiny thing over there? Oh, it's Super Nina and Super Roberto. Great, we're all in.
Super Pocoyo. Yeah. Super Pocoyo. Super Pocoyo.
Oh, sure thing, Pocoyo. You're Super Pocoyo. Well, he is right. It could also say Super Pato.
Super Pocoyo.
Now hang on, you guys. Don't fight.
Super Pocoyo.
Remember, we are a super team. Stop it! Oh, thank goodness. Elly, could you please help us knock some sense into these two? Huh? Super pink elephant? Hey, you guys, stop right there. Nina, help us out, please. Fight? Guys, Fred Fury is right. We need to stop arguing. Fantastic! There is the super aircraft. Fred Fury is opening the gates. Oh no, that wasn't the way out. There they go!
Super Pocoyo!
Guys, you need to stop fighting. Remember, we need to work as a team. Oh, by the way, who's flying this craft? Super Doll? But no! All right. Are you ready to fight the... Elly? Oh, Super Doll. That's better. We are ready to fight now.
Bad monster!
Wow, that's one big robot.
Super Pocoyo.
Thank you.
The hole is way too small. Awesome! Now we can go in. This is our chance to win the fight. Okay, this must be the main computer. And that looks like some kind of switch. That's it. Roberto is right. This switch position makes the robot evil. And that other position makes it a good robot. Bye-bye, little alien. You did it, guys. You have been super brave. You are a super team. No, wait. I mean, you are really a group of truly... No, I got a better idea. You are some super friend... No, I got it. You are the League of the Extraordinary Super Friends.
There's Pocoyo. Hello, Pocoyo. Pocoyo? Pocoyo?
No.
No what, Pocoyo?
Not Pocoyo.
You're not Pocoyo? Well then, who are you? Can any of you tell me what Pocoyo is today?
Superhero!
Oh, I see! The cape, the P. You're a superhero! Super Pocoyo!
Super Pocoyo!
Oh dear. Wow, you certainly are being a superhero, Pocoyo. Pato, I think Pocoyo wants you to play with him.
Super Pocoyo and Super Pato.
So, what's Super Pocoyo's first mission?
To
Oh, what a wonderful idea. Wow, Super Pocoyo is using his supervision to spot someone who needs his help.
Superbird stuck.
Stuck? Well, I'm not sure that she's actually... You know, Pato, Pocoyo's a superhero. He knows what he's doing.
Super Pocoyo!
Spotted someone else who needs help, have you? Lula? Well, Elly looks like she's just having a rest.
No! Elly's stuck! Super Pocoyo!
No, Elly, I think Pocoyo was just trying to... But don't you see? Pocoyo was just pretending to... Oh, dear, Pato. I don't think Pocoyo is feeling so super after all now, is he? Maybe you should go and cheer him up. Pato? Oh, Pato, it's your hat! Help! Pato can't see where he's going! Oh, there must be someone, somewhere, who can help Pato! Can any of you think of anyone who could help Pato?
Super Pocoyo can help!
Good work, Pocoyo. This has been a super day after all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Elly. Oh, look. Elly has some very nice shoes. Hi, Pato. And Pato has a stylish hat and a bow tie. Wonderful. Oh, hello, Pocoyo. Wow, those are some trousers. Oh, I see. Our friends are playing dress-up. What fun. The Martian Brothers Show. Sunglasses. Ribbon.
Ribbon, it's a ribbon.
Hello, Caterpillar. Can you tell Caterpillar what Elly is wearing? Can you tell Caterpillar what Pato is wearing? Can you tell Caterpillar what Pocoyo is wearing? It seems Caterpillar wants to play dress up too. Oh my, that shoe is too big. That hat is too big too. Oh dear, and the trousers.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a frog!
Very good! A frog! Poor Caterpillar can't play dress-up. What's that, Elly? You say Caterpillar can wear Pato's bow tie? Oh, Caterpillar! What a lovely ribbon!
Trousers. Shoes. Hat. Sunglasses.
Sunglasses. Bow tie. Ribbon.
Time after time before time. Hello, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hi,
Nina.
Having a picnic, I see. Mmm, and something smells good.
Mmm.
Oh, cupcakes, Elly. I bet you worked hard on them. They look marvelous. Well done.
Yeah!
Oh dear, Elly. And you worked so hard. No cupcakes today. What a pity. A machine that can take you backwards in time? Oh, so you can go back to before the cupcakes were smashed.
I think.
Brilliant. But how's it work? Incredible! We've gone back in time a whole minute. Guys, aren't you forgetting something important? No, Pocoyo, the banana peel. We can't let Elly slip on it again. She's coming! Hurry! Tuck in. You ate them all. Oh, I see. You'll just go back in time again and have a second helping. But, oh dear, where are we? Yee-haw! We're in the Old West. But it looks like Miss Elly isn't making cupcakes. Say that now we're in prehistoric times. Aha! The banana peel, of course. last, you're back in the present. And just in time for the cupcakes. Oh dear. Hard luck, guys. You're a bit late. No, wait! There's Elly. And she made more cupcakes just for you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Pocoyo, Pato and Elly. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Ah, it's a dressing up box. So, what do you think you'd like to do today? Do any of you know?
Dressing up.
Dressing up.
Ah, yes. What a good idea.
Story, story.
What's that? You would like me to tell a story? And you will all pretend to be the characters? Oh, that would be great fun. And I think it's safe to say that I'm rather a good storyteller. You all get ready now. Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lived a brave young prince. Oh dear. Wait. The prince is the one who has a crown. Can any of you tell me which one of our friends is the prince?
Pocoyo!
Yes, it's Pocoyo. Sorry, boys. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, this young prince was called Prince Pocoyo.
Hooray!
And he was very brave. And very handsome. And strong. Oh, and tall, of course.
Yes.
But this prince wasn't alone in his kingdom.
Oh, no.
was also a beautiful elephant princess who had... No birds. Thank you, baby bird. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Anyway, she was without doubt the sweetest and most charming creature in the universe. So dainty and beautiful and strong.
Yes, well that's very impressive, Ellie. I'll say this isn't quite the story I was expecting to tell. But I think a weightlifting princess will work out very well indeed. Now, where were we? Yes. This delicate and dainty elephant princess loved the prince. And the prince loved her. Ah, this isn't going so badly after all. But she was desperately sad because she couldn't go out to play with Prince Pocoyo because a crazy duck would not let her. He was a cruel and crazy... Come on. Oh, do come on, Pato. You're supposed to be the baddie. Look, I promise you can be the prince next time. All right? Please? I promise. Good. So, this crazy duck was really cruel and crazy. More crazy? Just a little bit more crazy, Pato. Ah, that's perfect. Thank you, Pato. So, when he saw the young prince approaching, he decided to frighten him away forever with his fierce, terrifying, fire-breathing dragon. Yes! Who jumped towards the prince and started to kiss him. Oh, dear. Anyway, after this, the crazy duck was so furious, he sent his best warrior, the Sleeping Knight, and his terrible army. Hello again, baby bird. This time, Prince Pocoyo was surrounded. No escape. What could he do? Invite them all to a picnic? Why did I ask? And to have a little sleep in his bed? But Crazy Duck was really angry with him, so angry that he started to water his plants. And the Elephant Princess went for a ride on her scooter. Elly, but this is not a... And Prince Pocoyo played in his car, and the crazy duck bought himself a canary, and... Oh, wait a moment. Now I get it. Yes. Once upon a time, there were some great friends who just love playing together.
Yippee!
What a wonderful story. Hooray for stories and hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Pocoyo and Elly and Pato.
Hi.
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Elly out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Elly, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Elly, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh my. You're balloons now. Phew! You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it? It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Thank you. I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off! Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. Mm-hmm. See you soon.
Come on, everybody sing with me. Everybody dance with me. Are you ready? Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
And eyes and ears and mouth and nose.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
And eyes and ears and mouth and nose.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees,
shoulders, knees and toes.
Knees and toes.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
And eyes and ears and mouth and nose.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Let's go. Head, shoulders, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes.
Magic words. Hello, Pocoyo. Can anyone tell me what Pocoyo is playing with?
Blocks!
Blocks? No. I think what Pocoyo is playing with are... Oh, my. Well, yes, they are blocks after all. Well, blocks are fun to play with, too. Look, everyone! Hasn't Pocoyo built a lovely tall...
Yeah.
What? That's odd. Where'd that clock come from? That's a great idea. A nice nap in the cool shadow of a magnificent leafy
tree.
It all looks very tasty, Pocoyo. Perhaps a snack will do. So, are you going to make a sandwich? Good idea. First, he starts with a slice of...
Bread!
Next, a slice of
cheese.
Oh, yummy, Pocoyo. You've made a delicious
manjo.
Well, that's nice. If you can't eat your sandwich, at least you can play the banjo. Yes, there's nothing more fun than playing on a
trampoline.
I agree, Pocoyo. Let's get to the bottom of this mess. Oh, now I understand. Nina is playing magic words.
Furry.
Oh, very good, Pocoyo. A party. Something's missing.
Here comes Daddy Ducky. And now the baby duckies. And here comes comes Mummy Ducky. Now here comes Daddy Ducky. And now the baby duckies. And here comes Mummy Ducky. Now here comes Daddy Ducky. And now the baby duckies. And now the baby duckies. And now the baby duckies.
Halloween Tales. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
All dressed up for Halloween, I see. Hello, Nina. And where's your costume? You don't know what Halloween is? Well, Halloween is a special night where everyone has fun trying to scare each other. See? A scary, mad mummy. A frightening wolf man. And a spooky ghost pirate. What's that, Potto? You're going to tell a scary story? All right, Potto. Let's hear it. Once upon a time, there was an old pirate. He roamed the darkest, dark ocean, carrying a trunk that was full to the brim with yummy candies. Suddenly, from out of the scary fog, a ghost ship. The ghost pirate sent a giant octopus to steal the trunk. Turning all the candies into really terrifying ghost candies. Oh well, I suppose that wasn't so scary, was it? Pocoyo, would you like to try?
Yeah!
Once upon a time, there was an ordinary boy who, when the moon was full, became the terrible, hair-raising, unbearable wolf boy. Well, the wolf boy just wants to play fetch. Would you like to try?
There once was a mummy who went to the cemetery one dark and stormy night to have a lovely picnic with her dolls. And when a strange and haunting music started to play, they all had a zombie dance party. Well, Nina definitely isn't scared by that. Oh my! Who can that be? Trick or treat! Now that was a good scare! Happy Halloween!
Pocoyo?
Hi.
It looks as if Ellie's waiting for something. I wonder what she's waiting for. It looks like a parcel. Oh, goody. A very pink parcel. Can you tell Pocoyo who this parcel is for?
Elly!
That's right! It's a parcel for Elly. What could it be? Oh, quick, Elly, open it! It's a pair of shoes. Ellie's got a pair of really fancy dressing up shoes. Pocoyo, I think Elly would like you to help her put on her new shoes. Lovely shoes! Elly wants to know if you like her new shoes.
Yes, we like them.
We love them.
Stay.
Oh, Elly, are you planning on wearing your new dressing up shoes to play? What's that, Elly? You need to take a break. Another break already? Is it your shoes? I think Ellie's shoes are really hurting her.
Can Pato have the ball, Elly? What's that? Oh, it's just a little smudge. It's time for bed now, Elly. You can wear your shoes again tomorrow. Oh, dear me. It looks like Elly really likes her shoes. Oh, Elly, how ever will you be able to walk in those shoes? Oh, dear. Elly says that she doesn't want to play today. Pato, you know, I'm not so sure that's a good idea. Elly, that wasn't very nice. Pato was only having a bit of fun.
Poor Pato.
Elly says that she's very sorry. Pato? Pato? What do you think? Should Elly play with her friends?
Play!
Yes, I think Elly should play with her friends too. Wow! Look how you can play without your fancy shoes on! Hooray for Elly! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for playing! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Space Postal Service. Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late. And we have liftoff! According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato? I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Tory Dories know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. At last you found him. He's wondering what took you so long. The Vamoosh is out of fuel. The sun will take you back home. Welcome home. Good job. Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird! Chicks dig me. Good morning, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone. How wonderful. But still no mother. You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes, Pocoyo takes care.
Huh?
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Elly helps Pocoyo.
Elly? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Elly, will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks? This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato. What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh, their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all.
Hello, Elly. It certainly is a lovely day for a picnic, isn't it? Oh dear, that sounds like thunder. Perhaps you should pack your things so they don't get wet. Oh, it wasn't thunder at all. It was just Pato playing his drum. Here we are again, good as new. Oh, can any of you tell Elly what or who is missing from her picnic? There, there, Elly, there's no need to panic. I'm sure your dolly's here somewhere. When was the last time you saw it? Elly? Oh, Elly, surely you don't think the Pato took your doll? You wouldn't do that, would you, Pato? You see? Elly, this really isn't very nice. But Elly, Sleepy Bird couldn't have taken your doll. Elly, this really is too much. Now, Elly, Caterpillar couldn't possibly have taken your doll. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Elly, won't you please calm down? Elly is upset because she's lost her doll, Pocoyo. What's that, Pocoyo? You think you can help Elly? What's this?
Detective Pocoyo.
Oh, I see. This must be Detective Pocoyo's office.
Sit.
You see, what Elly is trying to say is that she needs someone to help find her doll.
Looks
like Detective Pocoyo is searching for suspects. I don't think Pato took the doll. We were there. We would have seen him.
You?
I think Pocoyo wants to know if any of you took the doll.
Pocoyo.
Detective Pocoyo seems to be tailing another suspect.
Not yet.
Now, Elly, we mustn't rush Detective Pocoyo. Finding missing dolls can take time. Detective Pocoyo has gone back to the scene of the crime. Elly wants to know if you've found anything yet. Look, Elly! It's your doll! No, I mean, it really is there! Can all of you tell Elly where her doll is? You must have packed it away when you heard the thunder and thought it was going to rain. Mr. Detective? Elly says that you can stop looking. Yep, I suppose that's case closed.
No.
No? Something about Ellie's behaviour seems awfully fishy to Detective Pocoyo. Elly had her doll all along. Detective Pocoyo thinks you owe your friends an apology, Elly. Ah, it really is a great day for tea parties and mysteries. Hooray for Detective Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon!